Hey guys, this will serve as both a first impression and a bit of an update to my N64 save dumping guide. My previous $50 method was the cheapest I could find at the time, but it required a bunch of steps and gear. You needed a Game Shark, a working N64, a memory card, a controller adapter, and just getting a save safe on your PC required a bunch of steps. All that to back up a single save file. Then if you want to use that save file on an emulator, you need to open up a hex editor and scan it for some values. It was a bit of a mess. So today we'll try out this new cart dumper instead. For just $15, it promises to allow us to directly connect our games to our PC, so with just a few clicks we can back up not just our saves, but our ROMs too. It doesn't come with any instructions, so let's walk through the process a few times just to see how easy it will be to back up your saves. Before we start, I'd recommend checking this list linked in the description to see what save method your game uses. While this can back up save files stored on the cartridge, many games actually use memory cards, aka controller packs, instead. For those, watch my old guide section on dumping N64 memory cards. But the most common way games save the cartridge is eeprom. This is the easiest to work with, so we'll test one of those first. A small number of games use SRAM as well. We can back these up just fine, but you can't just copy and paste these into an emulator. You'll need to convert them first. But that requires extra software and steps, all for a small handful of games. So I'll show you how to back these up and keep them safe on your computer, but for use in an emulator, you'll need to follow a separate guide. The final type is flash storage. We had no option to dump these before, but now we can, so I'll briefly cover those as well. And don't worry, you don't need to memorize this list or the save types. The cart reader can actually tell you what save format your game uses as soon as you plug it in. I'll show you that in a bit. The first game we'll start with is Star Wars Episode 1 Racer, and according to the list, this is an eeprom game. So grab your cart reader along with a USB cable. I'm using a Nintendo branded one for my Pro Controller to make it even more efficient. And I found that if you plug the cable in first, it does not seem to work, so maybe plug in the game before the USB-C cable. Also, if you're just taking your game card out of storage, make sure to clean them a bit first. Ideally, you don't want to blow them off because that can cause corrosion in the long term. And once it's all set up, you should see a new removable storage pop up on your computer called N64. We don't need any fancy software or drivers for this to work, so it should support Windows, Linux, and probably Mac too. The first file you want to check out is cart test. This will tell us the name of the cartridge, Star Wars Episode 1 Racer, along with the save type. If you see not present in all three of these save types, that probably means your game uses a controller pack or even password saves. But as you can see here, we have an eeprom save, so we should be able to get this up and running in an emulator. If you see SRAM details here, this video will help you get it saved safely on your computer, but it will not be working in an emulator. Flash ROM or flash storage should be transferable too, but it may not be as easy to import as we'll see later. So we'll start by working with eeprom. That should be quick and easy. In your cart reader storage, remember it's called N64, you'll find a few different files. In this example, we have rom.eep, rom.n64, romf.eeprom, and romf.z64. Both this .eep and eeprom files are our saves, and I'm not entirely sure what the difference is. I think there might be two slightly different formats. But the two .n64 and .z64 files are our game's ROM, so you can copy these if you want to make a legal backup of your game. For what I understand, .n64 is a slightly older format, so we use .z64 here instead. And I would not recommend trying to rename or run the file from here, just copy it anywhere on your computer first. And it may take a while to copy as it has to read the actual bits directly from your cartridge, so give it a few minutes to finish. And once it's done, you can rename it to whatever you want. Just make sure to leave the extension. So I'm going to change the name from ROMF to Star Wars, making sure to leave the .z64 at the end. And now we need our save file. Cart test says we're working with an eeprom. We'll do the other two types later. But again, anything that's not our N64 or our .z64 should contain our save data. So let's copy the ROM.eep file. We'll transfer it to our computer first. And once done, ideally I'd recommend giving it the same name as your ROM. So I'm going to call this StarWars.eep. Alright, now that they both have the same name, let's load up the ROM in our emulator to make sure we dumped it correctly. So I'm going to load up the ROM we just dumped using Simple64, and after a couple of seconds the game loads up just fine. But getting a little bit further in, you may notice our save file is empty. And that's because a lot of emulators and front-ends like Simple64 or RetroArch need our saves to be in a specific folder. So just Google the name of the software you're using along with save file location, and that should tell you exactly where you need to put your save. Okay, it looks like this uses our app data folder, so I can just copy this into a new Explorer window and paste it in, or you can browse there manually. and once you open a new Explorer window, you should see all our saves, including the one for the game we just launched. If you see a bunch of other saves but don't see the one for the game you just ran, you may need to progress a little bit further in the game to manually save. Here's an example for RetroArch. As you can see here, it gave us a save file name that matches our ROM, however the extension is different, nen.srm. So first we need to close the game, or even the whole emulator, and then copy over our dumped save file into the RetroArch save folder. Now we need to make sure our name matches. You can rename it yourself, or you can copy and paste the name. Delete the old file, and rename your imported new one. And now RetroArch should load up the save file just fine. Simple 64 makes it a little bit more tricky, as it uses standardized ROM names. As you can see here, it went Star Wars Episode 1, Racer, blah blah blah, but the process is the same. With the game closed, copy the game's name that the emulator wants, and paste it on the file you want to import, including the proper extension. Now boot up the game, and the emulator should read it just fine. And honestly, that's all you really need to know about backing up cartridges. It's really just that easy. Just remember to unplug the USB-C cable before switching games, and if you don't see the N64 drive show up, or you see this jumbled text in the cart test, just try cleaning your cartridge first. That worked for me. And as I mentioned before, SRAM games like Legend of Zelda can have their ROMs dumped, and their saves can be archived too, just copy the RAM file, but they don't seem to work in an emulator as is. I also tried games like Pokemon Stadium 2 that use flash storage, but I was not able to get those imported into an emulator either. I did, however, get them loaded up in a save editor, so just like SRAM, your data should be safe, but not really usable on PC. I'll post a link to a fix in the description if I ever find one. And one last thing to test is transferring an emulator save to a real N64 cartridge. And before you get too excited, no, you can't overwrite your N64 carts for other games. This is just for putting save files from emulators or online onto your cartridge. I found this 100% save file for Star Wars Racer. Okay, we have a save file, let's extract it somewhere. And now, looking back at our N64 drive, our save file is called rom.eep in all caps. So let's rename our downloaded save to match. rom.eep, again, all caps. Now let's just drag and drop it, overwriting the one on our N64 drive. Give it a second, and it should be done. Now let's head over and boot up our real N64 and see if the save file loaded okay. Alright, we have our emulator for our old save on the left, and on the right we have our real cartridge, and let's see if our save shows up. Okay, loading up our profile. Okay, there we go. Our old save file with the three sets of profiles is on the left, and if you look on the right you can see our cartridge for one single profile of 100% completion. So it looked like it worked. So yeah, overall this is a very cool adapter, and a huge improvement in both time and cost over dumping saves the old way. I still wish I had the option to output emulator compatible SRAM saves, as well as flash, and it would be nice if the ROMs and saves were auto-labeled so they don't just show up as ROM each time. But overall, I really like this product, and I think it's a great choice for under $15. After I started on this video, I learned this product may be designed based on or copied from the Dream Dumper 64 project, and if so, huge shoutouts to that project as well. If you're looking to build one yourself, and you want better quality or better support, maybe you should look at that instead. But I'll still leave what I ordered linked in the description below. And like with anything from AliExpress, if the listing's sold out, just buy it from a different seller after checking their feedback. Anyway, thanks for watching, and see you guys in the next video. Bye!